The Rockwell Hardness Tester is located in room 110 of the Plastics Analysis Laboratory. The purpose of the Rockwell Hardness Tester is to use ASTM standards to find an accurate hardness measurement for the desired workpiece. The machine works by applying a load to an indenter and measuring the penetration of the material. If your workpiece is too large, you may need to get a pair of clippers from behind the fume hood. This way you can trim down your sample so it will easily fit on the anvil of the Rockwell Hardness Tester. The materials you need are your sample piece, a ruler, your ID badge, clippers, as well as safety goggles. Make sure to use caution when using the clippers so you do not cut yourself. We decided to trim our specimen so that no material would hang off the side of the anvil. The material, however, does need to be large enough so that the entire surface area of the indenter will fit on the workpiece. A chart is located behind the hardness tester. Use this to decide on the correct scale. The scales are denoted by a single letter, which determines the load in the indenter that will be used. The R scale is appropriate for most plastics. For extra precision, a blue binder beside the hardness tester has a table of the appropriate scale for specific polymers. Locate the correct indenter for the scale selected. We are using the R scale, which uses the half-inch indenter. Simply place the indenter inside the machine and it will stay in place. On the left side of the machine, you can find the control panel. This is where we will turn the machine on. Make sure that the other switches are set to auto, dial, and the loading BCD switch will not be used. The machine output screen should read 100, indicating the machine is ready to run the test. If the output screen reads anything other than 100, toggle the machine's power from off to on. This will reset the machine. A dial on the right side of the machine will change the load. This load should match whatever scale you selected. For R, 60 kilograms is appropriate. Warning: proceed with caution. This machine uses enough force to cause harm to the human body. Do not start the machine with body parts in between the anvil and the indenter. Rotate the anvil adjustment clockwise in order to raise the anvil. You can also turn the anvil adjustment counterclockwise to lower the adjustment. Raise the anvil so that it is approximately 1.5 inches from the indenter height. Place your specimen on top of the anvil and begin to turn the handle, raising it at a medium to quick pace until an audible click is heard and felt. This indicates that the specimen is in the correct position and the machine cycle has triggered. Wait for the machine to cycle. As the machine cycle is run, the output will begin dropping in value to a negative number. It will then increase to a positive number and stop. If the machine does not go to a negative number, the cycle was done incorrectly. Once a number on the machine output has settled to a value, the cycle is done. This is the Rockwell hardness value that corresponds to your chosen scale. Turn your anvil adjustment counterclockwise in order to lower the anvil. Remove your specimen. Next, turn the power on to off position. You may notice that if your anvil is not low enough, you will not be able to remove your indenter. Further lower the anvil and then remove your indenter. Make sure to place it in the same rack that you found it in the correct position. Your workstation should be cleaner than you found it when you first began your test. Remember, before using the Rockwell Hardness Tester, it is important to ensure that the proper scale is selected for the material being tested. The machine's indenter and load setting should match the requirements for the given scale. After the machine has been set up, raise the anvil until it clicks to start the cycle. Wait until the cycle ends and record the hardness value. For more information on operating the Rockwell Hardness Tester, see Professor Larson.